Gentlemen, I'd like to call to order the special meeting for the Oxnard City Council for May the 12th, 2021. Roll call and posting of the agenda.
Councilmember Pasua.
Here.
Councilmember Madrigal.
Here.
Councilmember Turan.
Here.
Councilmember Lopez.
Here.
Mayor Pro Tem McDonald.
Here.
Mayor Zaragoza.
Here.
We have a quorum.
And the posting the agenda, Madam Clerk.
Yes, Mayor. The agenda for this meeting was posted in the City Hall bulletin board on May 10th, 2021. Thank you.
And please join me for the salute to our flag.
States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Okay. And also like to share with you that we have a couple of speakers or public comments. We have Douglas Partello, followed by James Lavery. Douglas Partello for 3 minutes. Oh, you got to call him first, Madam Clerk. Okay. Mm-hmm. We're going to call all the speakers at this time.
Thank you.
So the clerk is contacting Mr. Partello by phone.
Mr. Partello?
Hello?
Hi, Mr.
Yes.
Partello. You have 3 minutes to speak.
Yes, good evening, Mayor Zaragoza, City Council, staff, and public. When a judge comes right out and tells the city that this is very unlikely to succeed, why keep going? Why keep costing the taxpayers more for an ill-conceived, ill-fated crapshoot that is not founded on good data and not supported by the law? The judge found no evidence of poor performance from AMR Ambulance or Ventura County EMS Service, which was the key reason given to make the separation from the county EMS system and break the joint powers agreement. What has Oxnard come up with that might change your mind? I think we are all waiting to hear that. Oxnard wants to kick AMR and VCEMS to the curb and makes a $20 million contract with another private ambulance company, Falk. What is to say that Falk is any better? They are a private company, just like AMR, not a nonprofit organization. Do they employ a far different business model than AMR? Another roll of the dice. VCEMS has been doing this for quite well for 50 years. Oxnard has never run an EMS ambulance service. What makes Oxnard think, with zero experience, that they can do a better job? Oxnard has a hard time maintaining the roads, medians, parks, and public space landscaping. And they can run this? We are not talking about a dead bush or a dead tree here. We are talking about human lives here. Proposition 218 and 26 are problems for trying to make money off a public service such as ambulance transport. Most likely we will be in the red, not the black. Chula Vista runs a significant cost, which comes from the general fund. It was further stated that a private company would need to be found until Oxnard got their program up and running. I don't believe anything has changed. This is pretty much a moot point, as this plan is going down in flames in court. I would like to ask the city manager, how much will Oxnard have paid in the initial startup and legal fees thus far for this gambit? I know there's a Trident contract for billing, $500K for 10 monitors and 10 chairs, $150K for startup costs for Falk. Did I miss anything? Oh yeah, the lawyer costs. please tell the public how much on this. Their insurance reimbursement, if it falls short, that will come out of the general fund. So please stop now. Don't pursue this any further and waste any more money. Thank you.
Thank you. James Lavery.
Mr. Lavery? Mr. Lavery?
Yes.
Hello, you have 3 minutes to speak.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate the opportunity to speak. I'm going to kind of reiterate some of the points the first speaker said, referring to the judge's decision. Under the public interest section of the document that the judge released, not approving the order that the city wanted, it says the city argues that the public interest favors the requested relief because public policy favors local control over the provision of EMS and favors public ambulance service providers over private providers. This latter argument is perplexing, since city purports to contract a private ambulance service as the second largest ambulance company in the country. So think of that. In any event, the public policy as set forth in the EMS Act favors control at the county level, which will not be served if the preliminary injunction is granted. City also argues that the current ambulance services provided by county are substandard. The county agrees this is a proper public interest considerations, but city's argument is not supported by admissible evidence. I'm going to repeat that. City's argument is not supported by admissible evidence. Additionally, city does not explain how its own proposed service will be immune from the quality of services issues allegedly suffered by the current provider. So somebody needs to explain to me and the public, why is the city spending so much money on this issue when it hasn't been proven at all that it really is an issue? I have never heard of this issue coming up as service in Oxnard being substandard. It hasn't been on any social media, in any public document. There's no incidents of people suffering or not getting to the hospital in time because of lack of ambulance service. None of that. And this came before the judge. The city, maybe the city has evidence that they haven't pointed to yet. Another thing the judge says is about the other entities that this exclusive operating areas covers, Port Hueneme, where the Santa Claus is, Nyland Acres, and in El Rio. What's going to happen to these people if the city was able to, not get away with this? I mean, get the contract. What would happen to these? It would be financially infeasible for anybody else to service that area. So I just don't get this, because the county and the city coordinate and cooperate on so many different issues.
What time is that?
Thank you. Thank you. Our next item in the agenda is closed session. Mr. City Attorney. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Mayor. The City Council will recess to a closed session pursuant to Government Code Section 54956.9, Subdivision D1, to confer with its attorneys. The matter being discussed is City of Oxnard versus County of Ventura.
And Mr. City Attorney, potentially we might come back with an announcement. We're not sure yet.
Correct. There may be a report out of closed session once we're completed with closed session.
Thank you. We're going into closed session. I'd like to announce we're back from closed session, and we have an announcement by our city attorney, Steve Fisher.
Thank you, Mayor. By unanimous vote, the city council has given its legal counsel approval to seek appellate review regarding the denial of the city's motion for preliminary injunction in the action entitled City of Oxnard versus County of Ventura et al., which concerns the provision of ambulance transport services in the city.
Thank you, and we are adjourned. Thank you so much.